Welcome to another edition of the Recruiting Scoop. I'm Jerry Johnson, and I have more good news for Red Raider fans out there as Texas Tech has picked up yet another football commit as Joey McGuire and his recruiting staff are just on fire on the recruiting show right now. As a matter of fact, it's the open contact period that opened up on Sunday, and Coach McGuire is making the rounds in Lubbock, including to Lubbock Coronado, and that's where he picked up his most recent commit in the form of 2023 linebacker John Curry, who, oh, by the way, is a legacy. His dad played football, and his mom played basketball at Texas Tech. So that's pretty neat, the fact that both his parents were athletes at Texas Tech, and now he's committed to the Red Raiders. And looks like, you know, he's going to end up being a Red Raider himself. So that's, I think that's really cool. And another thing is, not only are you keeping local talent in Lubbock at Tech, but you're keeping legacies at Tech. And we all know, if you've been following Tech recruiting for the last 10 years, man, they've really struggled with legacies. So that's just good news all the way around. So he's the fourth commit for Texas Tech's 2023 class. So that's guys that are juniors right now. And that class ranks, according to 24/7 Sports, 11th nationally and second in the Big 12. Now, it's still really early in the recruiting cycle for 2023, but still, I mean, what a great start to the class. I mean, this is almost unheard of for Texas Tech. So, and it's built on local guys. Isaiah Crawford, a four-star edge rusher from Post, 6'4", 210 pounds, is atop the board there. Caden Carr is also, I mean, is a legacy because his brother played here, of course, played several positions, including tight end and offensive line for Texas Tech in his time as a Red Raider. But Caden Carr is 6'5", 300 pounds, all right, as a junior in high school out of Amarillo. So that's really good. Calvin Simpson Hunt, which, of course, you know, we've interviewed all these guys. You can find on, you know, of course, on Inside the Red Raiders. But I talked with Calvin Simpson Hunt last week, and a really interesting dude and a really underrated DB. I was shocked that he didn't have a rating and Tech was his first offer, but he said he didn't really need to wait for anybody else to offer. The fact that the coaches believed in him was why he pulled the trigger on Texas Tech. And then John Curry. So that's four commits for the 2023 class. Now keep in mind, Texas Tech had just nine commits for the 2022 class when Joey McGuire got here just, 3 weeks ago? And now, of course, he's already picked up several commits, a couple former four-star guys in the transfer portal. 2022 class, 2023 class, big time commits, already has, you know, a highly rated class, so he's doing work. And John Curry, though, sticking with him, I haven't seen him play in person, but man, I'm going to be very busy next fall watching all these local guys that are going to be future Red Raiders. I'm going to be going and scouting these guys, and that's just something I haven't really had to do because there's only been a couple of guys. And not all of them were, most of them were going to end up at Texas Tech. So things have changed. I'm going to be at a lot of games next fall, and it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm certainly going to go see John Curry. But I did interview him. He picked up the offer earlier this month. He visited Texas Tech for the Oklahoma State game. And, I actually had a chance to talk to him about it. He said the visit went great. They got their weight and height and other measurements, and they ate, and they had a mini tour of the football facility. Then he went to the field. He said his favorite part was getting to meet up, with the players and everything. He said his dad, Ryan Curry, yes, did play football at Tech, and his mom, Ayers. What about Ayers? It's got to be Ayers, right? Jolie Ayers played basketball at Tech, so that's really cool. He said he did talk with Coach McGuire during the visit, and he said that basically he wants to build Tech's foundation around West Texas talent. So, I mean, it looks like that's exactly what he's doing. He's also really building up these positions of need. You know, he's really going after offensive and defensive linemen and DBs, and then now he's got a linebacker that, you got to be pretty excited about. 6'3", 185 pounds. Obviously, you want him to be bigger than that, but 6'3", is a good frame. I have watched his huddle, and, I mean, he looks good. He flies all over the field, so more good news for Texas Tech, Coach McGuire, and all of Raiderland is another local guy. It looks like he's staying home and playing for Texas Tech. So with that, I want to thank you for watching, and until next time.